it's the day of our first preview. We've just finished our tech last night. We've just done some work on the scene transitions this morning. Scene transitions, they're normally called. And we're going to do a dress rehearsal and then a first preview tonight. So it's the least uncomfortable moment in my professional life. Traditionally, the day of the first preview is always a bit frightening because you have to embrace the differences between your prediction of what the experience is going to be like and then the reality. And sometimes those things can be far apart, sometimes they can be very close. And that relative distance determines the rest of the week's work. So it's always a bit frightening because as a director, I suppose you thrive on control or a sense of control, and it becomes increasingly obvious that this thing's got its own energy and momentum, and today's the day to just watch how it careers either on or off the path that you've made for it, and how instructive or helpful that is. So it's quite an edifying day, really. What is the play about? I don't know. I mean, it probably feels as far away from the concern about, you know, what its meaning is at the moment, because that's going to just come like a sort of Steven Spielberg sort of crash zoom shot that's just going to come smashing into focus tonight when it engages with an audience, and that's going to be really, really instructive. So I could probably attempt to answer it, but I think it's kind of too late for that. It's up to me to be open to seeing how an audience interprets it, where they're understanding it, where they're not, and what comes across to them is going to be really instructive. What we discovered? Just that Nashville is one of the best places to work in the world. The team is just completely brilliant and dedicated. There's so many interesting, amazing, intelligent resources there people can draw on. It's just really wonderful, really great to work with such a good team. I've learned new respect for my company, my creatives, and my writer. I've learned that it's just about holding your nerve, isn't it, to preview. So we'll see. We'll see tonight. This week's challenge has got to be the kind of classic thing of using your previews to improve the show, to get closer to the vision, the writer's vision, the vision of the production. And not to be so cautious that you don't develop and grow, and not to be so foolhardy that the whole thing doesn't unravel. So it's kind of careful balancing acts where we just got to use all the time that we've got, that we're allowed to use, and to make the right interventions to help us prosecute the play's argument. So it's the big challenge, you know, because we get judged on September 1st. So the play keeps going throughout the autumn, and I don't believe in sealing a play and stopping its growth or its life, but we are going to be judged on September 1st, so, and that's the time of contractual we're allowed to keep working on the production. So very much heading for a week tonight to see what we've got. So maybe on our next little check-in, it'll be clearer. I mean, the main thing that I'm thinking at the moment is kind of dividing it up into these questions is all well and good, but the overriding feeling is one of terror and fear. You know, it's a really terrifying experience. And I don't know, you know, it's a days like this when you just think, why am I doing what I do? Because you've got so many people's hopes and aspirations, and as the director, you have had to shoulder those, and I'm sure I've done some of them well and some of them not so well. I'm just very nervous about, you know, doing good enough jobs so that the play can get across, and we can justify everybody's investment in terms of time and money, and the audience turning up to see it and expect a decent evening. You know, I'm nervous about all of those expectations.